Hello everyone, it's Mystic Juicer back with some more Yomi action. We've got Bearsona versus UTRALAW in Not Dead Yet tournament action. First to four, standard counterpick, full cast. Okay, bit of a rough start there for Zek, but UTRALAW pretty much guaranteed to be playing DeGrey. Yeah, and Bearsona going right into Lum. I'm actually a little bit surprised at that. Bearsona is a newer player. UTRALAW has been around the block a couple of times. Rapidly become a Yomi regular in tournament play. So let's see how he deals with this newcomer. And let's see what the Bearsona can do. So sticking with Lum again, we had I've already commentated a bit of this matchup before. Rough matchup for Lum. See how UTRALAW plays it. We saw Ping Warrior put on an incredible performance as Lum versus DeGrey against Xseth. Let us see if Bearsona has studied at the altar of... Oh, and we've got hands on. That's kind of cool. So we can see a little bit about the decision making that Bearsona is going through. Okay, chooses to immediately play the 7. Oh, gets punished by the Joker reveal. I don't think that was a good call, to be honest, to be playing the 7 there. We don't have guaranteed aces in hand. It's possible UTRALAW has one in hand, but if he does, you've got a 1 in 8 chance of getting that damage. Not too big there. Goes for the second turn dodge here. Is not going to get too much damage. Let's see if he plays the 9 throw or gets in with the queen or a 5 to roll the dice. He's kind of got not great options off of this dodge. Yeah, chooses not to play a card at all. Yeah, thought better of it. Perhaps revealed the dodge side of the 2 when he wanted the block side. Okay, goes for the other 2. Dodging again. Okay, power up for single ace. And I think we're seeing a bit of inexperience here on Bearsona's part. Having a 5-6-7 early game is pretty good against a character like DeGrey, where you're often playing against throw or dodge kind of a range. Nice bait of the Joker there. Didn't really have anything to follow that 6 up with except... queen, which isn't a great reveal. So getting some mileage out of that, building his hand back up slowly. Could elect to go for a cross up here with the 5, or just go for a block. UTRALAW may feel like he doesn't want to eat a cross up attempt and go for a... Ooh! Goes for the block instead, gets lit up. Again, this is not going to deal a tremendous amount of damage. I would choose to probably combo into the queen here. Nope, chooses not to, holds on to it. Is he gonna roll the dice? Yes, he does. Flips a 10. Actually, nice way of denying DeGrey the option of his ace dodge. So not a bad call there. He's got another big cross-up normal he can try to go for. Or since he's shown that he's willing to go for cross-ups, he could elect to switch it up. Okay, goes for the throw instead. Counting on the fact that UTRALAW would not wake up with an attack. And successfully lands that. Does not pump. That's fine. Seems reasonable in that instance. Still has an 8-card hand. Still does not have a tremendous amount of damage in terms of attacks. Using to power up throws. Again, I think he might get himself into a pretty tricky situation if he keeps that up. Already 3 9s in the discard, 1 6 1 10. Obviously, the tens, he doesn't have to use his throws. He has guaranteed damage in this matchup. Okay, dodge, dodge. Unfortunately for Bearsona, DeGrey's ace dodge returns to his hand. And it'll be interesting to see how often UTRALAW chooses to press the dodge button in a row here. What kind of a read does he have on Bearsona's play? Okay. Testing Bearsona, playing fairly conservative option in the matchup. Again, it's not punished very hard, even if he does lose combat to a throw. Okay, does choose to face down. UTRALAW does not commit. Gives the panda some additional cards. Does put him on knockdown. So UTRALAW's got a nice mix up here. He can go for a cross up attempt. And if he declares attacks, yeah. Very, very likely, I think, that he's going to go for a cross up here. Bearsona can, it's either like a 7 ace dodge, but I think cross-up attempt is very strong here. Okay, goes for the 7 instead. It's like the ultimate cross-up attempt. Are we going to see double ace? No, does not follow it up with a combo at all. Choosing just to deal 8 damage. We have one known ace in UTRALAW's hand. Bearsona gets one of his aces back. Gets rewarded with queen. Could be in a good spot here. I think UTRALAW is going to continue to press the dodge button until he is convinced not to. Ooh, there we go. So he played troublesome rhetoric to make the cross-up 7 attempt safe, and goes in for an okay amount of damage. This is going to get him another ace, so that's a pretty good use of his resources at least. Those double aces could deal a tremendous amount of damage if they land now. Lots of moral high ground saved up. Bearsona is basically on a attack block range right now. Nice! Gets the blackjack off. This is a chance for him to equalize and maybe take the lead a little bit. Okay, 8. Nice, 16 damage. Pretty good. Evens up the life totals. I think we're going to see UTRALAW go right back to ace dodging. He's like, oh, okay, I just got punished for attacking. He hasn't really shown that he's willing to throw yet. Yeah, there we go. So again, UTRALAW playing an opponent he hasn't played before. Newer opponent. He's probably going to lean very heavily on... his more conservative options. So he does have ace-ace, but it's probably safer for him just to... gets lucky with a hit confirm here. He's dangling the ace dodge in front of his opponent as much as possible. But now I think he's going to go in. We're going to see 3 into ace-ace. Yeah, there we go. So not a massive amount of moral high ground now, but still. There's a bit of extra damage on that three, and then a bit of extra damage on the aces. Takes a nice bit of life lead here. 20 hit points in the lead. And Bearsona desperately looking for throws. I expect to see UTRALAW go to Block City right now. Ooh, okay, chooses to throw instead. Perhaps expecting to catch an ace dodge. I believe the ace in Bearsona's hand is known. Okay, chooses to play a jack face down to get out of some potential damage. I expect that UTRALAW's hand is not particularly full of scary stuff. Oh, found the third ace. But again, I don't expect this to lead to much. He might have a face card. Ooh, okay, never mind. That could be, that's almost it. That's almost all of the damage. Damn. Yeah, queen into jack, or queen into king. Pretty tremendous damage, even if you're only two cards lower than your opponent. Okay, ace, ace. And if Bearsona doesn't draw a block or a throw, he is checkmated by ace on this next turn. Okay, chooses to find a card he can play. I mean, he does have the Joker to save himself, so that's not, it's not the worst. If I'm him, I'm probably playing a queen. No, plays the ace, gets thrown, and that will be game one. Okay, UTRALAW had some damage, and he had the Joker to make that very, very safe. Okay, let's look at game two from UTRALAW's side. Okay, Bearsona switching to Setsuki. Perhaps identifying that that was not a matchup he quite enjoyed. Setsuki, a pretty good character against DeGrey. She does have to worry a little bit about dying to, like, two hits. Okay, Bearsona starting with first turn block. So playing a playing an atypical Setsuki. Yeah, so UTRALAW actually getting rid of throws here. Now he does get a good he gets his ace dodge, so that's not bad. But Setsuki likes to throw a lot. Setsuki likes to throw a lot. And I don't know. I can't play DeGrey to save my life. I'm terrible at DeGrey. I really don't like his counter-hit style. I either play way too... Like, I can't thread the needle of, playing really risky, high-risk, high-reward duffs. You know, queen, five attack, that sort of thing, and playing really, really conservative ace dodge and blocks. So I tend to just get stuck on one extreme or the other and then get badly exploited. Okay, going to Dodge City. And I think against a newer player, I think you play Blodge a very, very high percentage of the time until they are willing to show you that they are not playing rock, paper, scissors. So they're not playing like a mix of all the different options and they're actually adapting to a very exaggerated style. Nice throw from Bearsona. Let's see what kind of combo he follows this up with. Like if you play a Blodge heavy style with some good starters when you've got the combos to convert off of them, you can really, really punish people who are playing, you know, randomly, who are playing, you know, not to be predictable. Because the kind of the value that they gain off of their combat wins is going to be on average lower than the value that you get off your combat wins. Okay, UTRALAW now has some damage in the corner. Bearsona is on three cards, so I should see a throw from UTRALAW. Maybe not a 10 throw. Ooh, okay. I like that. It's definitely playing a more I can beat you on my combat options style of Setsuki. If you're playing more conservatively with Setsuki, you're probably leading with Joker in hand, you're probably leading more attacks. Or are you just being more aggressive in general so that you can, you know, if you get ace dodged, you've got Joker to prevent really egregious damage from that combat reveal. And ideally, you're playing the matchup in such a way that your opponent has to follow up, like anytime they do get a combat win against your superior buttons, you really, really, really have to go in against your opponent, against Setsuki, and then Setsuki punishes you by having the Joker. So face downs, but does not play the actual Joker. 23, so making up for the for walking into the troublesome rhetoric. It looks like Mystic Deadman and Bob's match ended. All right, will we see UTRALAW ace dodge into queen into king for almost 700 damage? Actually, it's probably going to be almost no damage. Oh, gets hit by the throw again. Bearsona sending a message. Working on the perfect right now. Okay, loops throw into throw. Very likely that he has queens or throws in hand. So against a hand like that, if you think Setsuki has queens or throw, you punish throw. Ooh. Okay, wakes up with Joker. Bearsona. Ah, Bearsona. Ah, okay. I like it. All right, so we got tons of damage in hand. Setsuki should be pretty damn terrified. If she has a queen, she's probably spending it here. What does UTRALAW do? Ooh, goes for the seven. Okay. Are we going to see... I mean, he can't really get all that much damage off of this. Bearsona should absolutely face down to go down to one card. Chooses not to. So showing a bit of inexperience there. Okay, more troublesome rhetoric. What do you reveal here for troublesome rhetoric? Blocks? Okay, interesting. And then follow it up with king. That is probably the most conservative thing you can do. Punishes everything except queen reveal. There we go. Gets hit by queen. Calculated. The reads. So Bearsona knows a little bit what's up. He's played the game before. Okay, gets that hot six damage combo. Yeah, that's right. Can't be mad at that as UTRALAW. You're not risking all that much. probably choosing to keep the queen in that instance just so he's got more damage in hand that he can play later. Ace dodge into queen 3 jack is like 100,000 damage, basically. All right, we got a speed of the fox turn. Setsuki's often like to throw on these turns, and Bearsona is no different. Does he have enough damage to dump his hand? Calculating optimal combo. Four, five, six. Nice. Big damage. He is going to put himself at a 3-card hand, but he's got a ton of life lead to play with. Basically, any combat reveal is going to lead to death. He's got single ace for pressure. Immediate ace dodge. Does Bearsona know? Does he catch on? Could see Bearsona dodge here if he thinks that that was a mashed K. Yeah. Now, will UTRALAW dodge one more time before playing the Raw Queen? No, it's time for Raw Queen. Can he deal the damage? The degramage? Can he thread the needle? Find that throw, that greedy throw. Oh, yeah. Get got. So again, no moral high ground. Yeah, chooses not to play the three. The three is a fine dodge if his ace gets thrown, although to be honest, if he gets his ace thrown, he's probably dead, so doesn't matter all that much. Immediate queen. I would queen again. Oh no. UTRALAW knows he's a knower. So are we going to see throw into 2-3, or are we going to see queen? Throw into 2-3 is actually more damage, and it sets up for moral high ground. Okay, just gets the throw in. Gets the king. Dodge into queen king is 24 plus nothing. Okay, never mind. So this is not lethal. Could set up another knockdown though. And that is 2 queens spent. Okay, no, it goes for max damage. Puts him on the lethal clock. He's only got lethal off of throw or dodge. Cannot kill off of 2 attack reveal. Will he go for lethal is the question. Ooh, gets hit by the third queen. This is probably going to be it. We see the immediate face down. Bearsona should absolutely play into this. It's got the advantage of Setsuki. She doesn't need to respect face downs. Yeah, I need slightly more than that. So missed lethal there. Could have pumped the queen with one more damage. Holding on to the single card. Let's see. If he knows to hang on to sevens or eight or jokers. All right, it's the ace. Yeah, okay. So a bit of a misplay there by Bearsona. Could have pumped the queen with the ace, gotten lethal. Let's see if that comes back to bite Bearsona in the behind. UTRALAW could lay it all on the line with a throw. Oh! Just gets outsped. Buttons, Setsuki buttons too good. Bearsona goes up 1-1. Okay, UTRALAW switching to Valerie. I don't like this matchup. I think I'm on record as saying that. If UTRALAW feels all right in it and he feels like he can better exploit the habits he's noticed from Bearsona using Valerie, then that's fine. Starts off with a pretty good hand, actually. Goes in with the 4. Wow. I'm a little surprised at that. Reading the first turn throw. Footsie's confirmed. Johnny D, our footsie's-ometer in chat, letting us know. What kind of combo we got? Okay, not much, but we get the knockdown. Could have a good cross-up opportunity here. Or some good power-ups. Okay, UTRALAW in a position now where he does not have 3 normals to string together. Goes for the odd block, I think. Could be a throw. Very much doubt the throw, though. Yeah, there's the block. Gets thrown on knockdown. Good stuff from Bearsona, not taking the 50-50. Playing the greedier option to try to punish conservative blocking. Valerie loves to block in the early game. UTRALAW has not yet indicated that he's got a single ace yet, which is Valerie's dedicated I'm scared and in neutral against a character with good buttons button. There we go. Confirming ace. UTRALAW cannot yet play Yomi. He's got to play Valerie. He's got to assemble a hand. I would probably just block again. Yeah. Nice. Got to be brave about your blocking in the early game as Val. Got to spend just enough resources poking out and defending yourself against throws, and just enough resources blocking so that you've got a hand you can actually be threatening with. There we go. Mashing that neutral button. Hitting him with the orbs. Okay, has Joker, so is going to have a higher life total, which is very important against Setsuki. Could go for some sort of random button in neutral here. Bearsona has been playing some throws and some high normals. So, pretty good indicator that he doesn't have anything faster. Goes for the 3 attack. Yes. Pay dirt. So hopefully we draw. Okay, nice. Draw bold strokes off the 7. Oh, that's right. You can't play it after you've already revealed it. Got to do it with combat reveal. Probably going to empty at least the 4 and the 2 5s. Could hang on to the 3. It's never a bad idea to hold on to dodges. And this... Oh, okay. Just combos 3 cards. I would probably go for 2. 2 gets you the second ace, which means you can now throw into... 22 damage, which is basically half of Setsuki's remaining hit points. Right now, you can go for throw because you have the single ace to kind of pressure, as it's a 1.0 speed, and Bearsona still hasn't been able to get a speed of the fox. So he's probably stuck on the same bad hand that he was stuck on since the beginning. Ooh! Or not. Maybe the hand was awesome. 27 damage. Oh, baby. Mom, get the camera combos. All right. Finds a third normal. Again, low normals though. No, would prefer fives or sixes. Has already spent a considerable amount of fives. Oh no. Speed of the Fox Joker. That's bold. I like it. 17 damage in hand now. Or 17 additional damage in hand. It's going to be very dicey for UTRALAW to deal with. Bearsona getting the third ace back. Tons of damage in hand. UTRALAW drawing the second Joker. All right, he's going to need that. I'd like to see UTRALAW play the queen here. And then just Joker the dodge if he gets dodged. Okay, single ace. Willing to risk it. Now, Chromatic Orb does trade with Setsuki's single ace at 1.0 speed, but you know, trading 9 life for 10 when your opponent has life lead is not a good look. Okay, sinks the queen. Probably going to play the... Actually, I think you hold on to the king in case a jack shows up. Maybe play the 4 as well. Yeah. Just get that extra damage. 23, 6, so throw into 6 is 12, plus 8 is 20. There we go, just on time. We've got the jack. We can now safely, we can throw. I think in this position, you mash that 8. And you try to get throw 6, jack, king for lethal. You've got 2 jokers to follow up. There's nothing that Setsuki can do to kill you. Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, you can undercut. You can undercut instead. There we go, that's lethal. Wow. No face down from Bearsona. Did not believe. Oh, just play the king. Don't start calculating lethal now, man. What if he played an invisible Joker? He's gotta cover all of his options. Alright, game. No, you didn't, UTRALAW. Come on. All right, Bearsona sticking in the matchup. Does not switch to jack. Math confirmed hard. All right, kind of an awkward hand. Again, the ideal hand I think in this matchup for Valerie is. Like, you start with 4 normals, like a 2 and then 3 sixes, and then, you know, a 9 throw for your dedicated block and an ace or something like that. And a burst of speed. I think it's probably the ideal hand. Maybe actually, you know what, maybe start with a Joker as well, just so you can prevent that first... big damage. Okay, gets the 7 poked out by the queen. Should go into fairly big damage. Well, Bearsona not taking advantage of the hand dumping abilities of the queen, unfortunately. Could be either misreading the card. Or just not experienced enough with the game to recognize it. still holding his own against UTRALAW. Setsuki confirmed too strong. UTRALAW still going for throws. I don't agree with these early throws from UTRALAW. They're not going to lead into much at all. He just powered up for him, man. Think he's just going to hold on to his aces? Nah. Nah, we play those. Okay, see, now he's got something he can follow up his throws with. Oh, gets hit by the dodge. So Bearsona can set up a really nice turn if he throws here. Okay, just goes in with a jack. Gets his speed of the fox going. But does not get the cross up slash denial of dodge. That would make the turn particularly devastating. Still, working on a nice life lead right now. UTRALAW still not on a hand that he can really do much of anything with. He has not blocked successfully, or blocked enough successfully enough to assemble what he needs to be able to play Yomi. He's still playing assemble a hand E. And Bearsona doing what Setsuki does best, which is not giving your opponent room to breathe, especially Valerie. And this is why I don't like the matchup. It's stuck on an awkward hand and red a couple times. Just makes every... I think Valerie is one of the most susceptible to hand destruction, like, characters in the game. She really wants to play a footsies game. And Setsuki is just not a character that lets you do that. Okay, gets a combat win with the king. Again, can't really lead this into anything. Probably just going to leave it at 6. Yeah, good stuff. All right, he baits the Joker. That's not bad. That's a good combat win. It's a little bit less, a little bit closer to Setsuki having actually 70 health. Because of her typical cycling playstyle, she often has much more consistent high life than you would expect. Just because she's going to reach those Jokers much more often, much more consistently. It's kind of a snowbally character. When things are going her way, things go more her way. If she does get stuck on an awkward hand, then it can put things in a bad place. So this I like. I like the throw here when Setsuki is on a 3-card hand. It's very typical for Setsuki's to... Essentially, Setsuki has 3 very common ways to dump from that position. One is to dodge into something. One is to throw into something, and one is to play a face card into something. So throws beat all of that. It loses to face cards, but face cards do not deal damage on their own. And now that he's got the knockdown, he can go in with something. Okay, nice. Gets one normal off of the bold strokes. Let's hope he draws another normal. Ah. I think you go in here anyway, play the 3-4-6, you at least get another ace. Perhaps you even play the jack with 2 pumps, just to deal a bunch of damage. Yeah, I think we're going to see it. Already seen one Joker in the discard. Oh, does not go in with all of the cards he could have. I think that's actually a mistake. If he had hit with the queen, Bearsona would be at 21 health, and throw into ace-ace is lethal. I don't think the queen is going to do anything for him, because it's not a known card. I think you do spam queen here, though. Or maybe you just go for throw lethal. It's definitely 8 throw backed up by burst of speed or queen. And you do not pump the queen if you hit with it. Okay, there we go. Gets dodged, unfortunately. Oh, okay, it was the speed of the fox turn. Oh, no. No, 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 no. That was not good. Just got rid of his good throw. and have a much more awkward time winning the combat he does. You have to weight RPS, rock, paper, scissors, so much in your favor to get the combat wins against Setsuki's better buttons. Now you're in a position where you can't throw with the 10. Ooh. That's the queen et. Yep. And now we've got a lethal on the table for Bearsona, potentially. 17 means he needs to deal 7 more damage. So throw into anything into ace-ace is lethal. And 3-4, or like queen something, or jack something, or king something into anything is lethal as well. Now you do have the 9 throw. You can turn that into a 7.2 speed throw. Okay, good block. Defend yourself against one ace. Potentially puts Bearsona on single ace in hand, so he cannot throw into lethal. So I would probably go for a dodge here. No, dodge or queen. Queen is quite good as well. Because with throw off the table, it makes it more likely that he's either going to go for a single ace play again. Okay, hits him with the single ace. Again, not a huge fan. Well, I guess now he can throw into queen for lethal, probably. Yeah, 6 into 8 for the queen. 14 plus 2 discards is lethal. And he's got 2 jokers, so I think you go for the throw here. Well, queen or throw, again. But I would probably go for the throw. Okay, chips a little bit. Does put a few more cards into Bearsona's hand. We've got 2 known queens, although with 2 jokers, you really don't care if you're hit by a queen. You are just trying to win a combat off of attack or throw. Well, I suppose he could queen into lethal here as well. Okay, blocks again. Not sure why the blocks with two jokers as backup. There is nothing that Bearsona can reveal that will be lethal from this position, no matter what UTRALAW reveals. Bearsona pushing down back. Too scared to push a button. Pretty good indicator that there's no queen on the table, so throw or queen is still the play for UTRALAW here. If you want, you even 10 throw. And then if you lose, then the opponent definitely goes, oh, okay, he's definitely not got any throws anymore, so I can play blodge to my heart's content. Okay, more pokes. Bearsona definitely playing like he doesn't have any queens, so I think you go in with a throw here. But again, every turn you wait makes it more likely that he's drawn a queen, so... yeah, face down makes sense. Try to prevent, theoretically you can get hit with double ace. That puts you in a position where you are now dead to some combat reveals, right? With no opportunity to use your second joker. So you definitely have to you at least have to face down. You definitely are probably, you're very likely to be playing a joker if you have it, just not to take the risk. Oh no, UTRALAW, man, you gotta go in. You don't need to be afraid of attacks. Okay, comboing for damage here. Okay, puts him on 10. But this is functionally equivalent to the same position he was in last turn. Nothing that Bearsona reveals. Well, okay, he could reveal ace-ace. It's possible he has two aces in hand. No, went for single ace, and this should be lethal. So queen into a 9 and a 10. Yeah, okay, so you got the lethal. Okay, UTRALAW closes it out. So 3-1, he's got to win one more. Oh, shoot, no, it's 14 damage. Ah. Rats, forgot. I think it's 16. It's got to be Manelker, I guess. Okay, all right, closes it out. So he had, so long as he pushed a button there, UTRALAW was going to win that game. Or would have beaten that, the 9. There's no way Bearsona could have countered twice, so guaranteed lethal. Yeah, I don't know if I would call it swingy, to be honest. It feels very grindy. If it's being played, if Setsuki is putting the pressure on, it's really up to Val to make enough correct guesses to be able to play the game. Good first turn dodge here. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Bearsona definitely playing in a style very reminiscent of people who are new to the game. Now look at that hand. Oh my god. So if I'm Bearsona, I am playing the queen, or I'm playing the jack, and I'm dumping this hand. I think he went for a throw here. No, okay, went for the block. I have missed the fun of watching these games with a whole bunch of other people in the chat. I think that's when Yomi's at its best. People are getting nuts. But yeah, that's yes. Yeah, so that's kind of the there's you know, very very standard kind of progression in Yomi, the same way there is kind of analogous to the fighting, like the way I assume that, you know, if you're learning a fighting game works, right? At first you're just figuring out your character's buttons, then you slowly kind of realize, oh, okay, I should look for, you know, specific, these are my optimal combos, and this is how I, you know, once you've realized your where your combos are, you start realizing, oh, okay, you know, if I hit that optimal combo, I'm going to be low on cards. So you start realizing that card advantage is a thing, which means that you have to be blocking and playing normal attacks more, which is where the, you know, the early game stops being this. It can feel very random at first when you're playing. You know, because you're just playing cards to win combat. You're trying to win at the rock paper scissors part of the game, where later on you realize, okay, that's not actually the way you get wins. What you should be doing is making the, you know, you're minimizing the impact of losses and maximizing the impact of combat wins. So, you know, you playing blocks, you know, blocks and attacks in the early game. Blocks because you want more cards so that you can win in the mid game, so that you can assemble the combos and the cards you need to be able to sustain mid game pressure. And then, you know, because you're blocking, you know, block is so strong, therefore throws are very good. And normals in version 2, because they draw you cards, are the way that you defend yourself and build a hand in the early game, where you're not really playing normal attacks to get big damage early. You're playing normal attacks, I mean, depending on the character, but you're playing normal attacks so that you can prevent your opponent from keeping your hand sizes similar and gaining an advantage, and exploiting the relative value of their hand to yours in the early game. Right? If you're throwing with the intent to put on pressure in the early game, what you're actually saying is, I bet you have a worse hand than I do. I bet I can sustain my damage better with the hand that I have than you can, you know, do the same and also defend yourself profitably in a card efficient, damage efficient way that'll preserve the cards you need into the mid game in the early game. And Setsuki is that all over. She is at all times trying to win combat, because basically any combat win off of a throw or an attack is going to lead to card advantage. Like she sustains her damage by dealing you as much damage as she possibly can, as card inefficiently as she possibly can. It's a cool kind of inversion on the regular, the typical way that characters play, but it's often why people find her very, very frustrating. Because you can't make the same strategic calls against her. You can't say, oh, okay, another character I would expect you to conserve specific options in a way that, okay, so this means that you're actually... I don't have to think, okay, what if he plays a 2 or a 3 or a 4 or a 5 or a 6 or a 7 or an 8 or a 9 or a 10 or a jack or a queen or a king or an ace? Like, not all of these options are real, because not all of them are a way that your character is actually going to move into the mid game successfully. And so you can kind of anticipate what people are going to play. They're going to play more block heavy in the early game. They're going to play more unsafe combat options in the early game when hands aren't developed. But Setsuki just goes to war with the cards she's got. And she's got a bunch of damage in her hand, and she throws it at you as quickly as she can. And once she's done with that, she gets more damage. So that is often the difficulty that people have. And I will say that is typically against an optimized Setsuki, right? Bearsona is not putting pressure on in the same way that a Setsuki, like an optimal Setsuki, will at the moment. But, you know, that'll happen. It's everybody starts in this state. But yeah, then you have that progression, right? So you're starting with your buttons, you finally get combos, you start to learn how to play the game, quote unquote, you know, where you're doing this. Oh, okay, it's got you. You kind of feel the rhythm of a match. And then you move on to learning, you know, character-specific tricks, or specifically matchup-specific tricks. And then you've basically got it all down. Okay, big damage from UTRALAW here. He's got a 10-card Valerie hand. This could be over quite quickly. And again, does not optimize that. What is his hand like? Oh, see, I would definitely have tagged on. Oh, okay, you know, he's got the other two aces. Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't go for 4 normals and 2 aces. You get the 2 aces back, you can serve the 2 jacks. So, a couple of tips there, I would suggest. Nice dodge from Bearsona. Is he going to go into triple ace here? I think it's very likely. Okay, just goes for the throw. Notably throwing with the 8 instead of the 9. Bit of an error there. No reason not to throw with your slower throw. Also gives you an even number of even and odd blocks in case you're ever knocked down. Okay, UTRALAW, speed of the foxing this, or burst of speeding this, I should say. Ugh, too many speed names in this matchup. Just to prevent the combo. So I'm pretty sure that the three aces, or at least two aces in Bearsona's hand, are known. So it may look kind of silly to do that there, but it's essentially spending a 10 instead of a joker. And as UTRALAW does not have any jokers in hand, that is pretty good. Okay, still going to get his 18 damage this way, though. So no loss of efficiency. Bearsona staying in the game. Question is he going to power up the 7s and the 6s? Okay, at least the 6s, but I would also probably power up the 7s. That way you have dodge into ace-ace, or throw into 4-ace-ace, more notably, to get out of the hand. It has 2 9s, so can also dodge into ace-ace and then power up the 2 9s to get to one card. Okay, went for it. It's another normal attack. So long as he does not play the normal attack side, he is always going to have an opportunity to dump off of any of the combat reveals. All right, there we go. So let's see if he spots it or if he goes for the throw. I think you dump here. Definitely play the double aces. Nope. Plays it safe. Goes down to 4 cards on the draw. Has lethal in hand. Very likely to see a queen from UTRALAW if he has it. Especially if he's got a joker. No, it goes for the block. So that tells me he doesn't have the queen, probably. Yeah. Could have also defended himself with single ace, although, again, it still leaves him on that awkward turn clock. Okay, there's the queen. Picked it up on the draw. Defends himself successfully, fighting for life. Okay, UTRALAW evening up the life totals, needs to find 23 damage. 7 card hand. Valerie is definitely a character who can kill off of combat reveal here, so conservative plays are definitely the jack, or even the 2 attack at this point, just to find as much damage as you can. Nice, good dodge. Would have traded with the 7, but that's not a great trade. This is going to allow him to get the knockdown again. And then I think we probably see Esper Dash unless he draws a queen. Okay, could see a dodge here. Could see another 10 dodge. Although he has been dodging an awful lot. So I would like to see UTRALAW either block his way up or throw. Of course, he can't know. He can't know what's in his hand, but the last couple of combat reveals have been pretty awkward. Okay, goes for a wake-up attack. Would have lost to the kind of standard plays of dodge or just play the jack. Okay, now definitely has lethal in hand. Dodge into king is going to be lethal. Jack into king's lethal. Raw king is lethal. Throw king is lethal. It's true. It's true. When Setsuki wins with a block, you just feel insulted. Like, what? You're not even supposed to know how to use those. It's unfair. I need those cards to do what I do. You're just a block tourist. Are you mocking me? All right. Ooh, gets outsped by the single ace. UTRALAW is not out of the game yet. needs also one more combat win. Bearsona can power up the eights to at least get the So yeah, he has an opportunity to go for a tie here. And lacking tiebreaker rules. I'm not sure if there are tiebreaker rules, but nice dodge though. Oh, and actually went for the slow side of double ace. I'm very surprised. So that's a very clear mistake. And he has to pump this. Yeah, okay, there we go. Whew. All right, Bearsona takes the game. 2-3. He's got to win two more before UTRALAW wins one. Okay, will UTRALAW stick with Valerie or go for something else? I honestly don't like the switch to Valerie. I think he was doing fine as DeGrey. I mean, I think he took a combat loss, but I think he was doing fine combat-wise. It's tough not to let Setsuki get in your head, though. Oh, switching to Onimaru. Okay. I think, again, this is not a bad choice against Bearsona's Setsuki. I think against a very strong Setsuki, this is a bad matchup for Onimaru, though. Now, the nice thing for Onimaru in this matchup, he's got nines, right? He's got final authority, which means that he can actually defend, he can compete with queens and win on trades against queens. Although I guess he doesn't trade, he just wins outright. It can't be countered, so it obviates the ability on the 10. But he still has, he still has Oni struggles, right? He's going to struggle to deal with a character with a lot of dodges, which Setsuki definitely has. Setsuki can play a, ace-centric game. She's still very scary with throws. If Onimaru ever puts himself in a position where he's low on hand and doesn't have the tools he needs to defend himself, Setsuki can exploit him very, very nicely with lots of dodges if he's low on throws, lots of attacks if he's low on dodges, and just general nonsense. And you're never going to get a guard crush. Although you do punish throws very effectively. All right, I want to see Bearsona go for a huge combo here. Give me the big one here. Give me king attack. Pump the two eights into jack. All right, knockdown's fine too. He's got kind of scrambled eggs in hand though. So let's see if he can convert this into something. If he plays the queen here, he might be able to bait a final authority, which would not be much in Onimaru's favor. So I would go for the queen or a cross-up attempt here. Because as Oni, you might not feel pressured to do anything with block. Oh. Catches him with the king. King reveal's interesting. So I think that tells me that he was actually going for a final authority to challenge queen. Oh, does he have the dream? Aww. Rip the dream. Never quad king. Never lucky quad king. All right, Found some damage though. Okay, nice. Yeah, that's fair. So this is cool. It's cool to see new players. It'll be interesting to see in like you know 6 or 7 matches from now how Bearsona's doing. I think with the amount of resources available to the community, you can really accelerate the amount of learning, the speed with which you can pick up the game and what you need to be successful. So big damage here is 4 into jack, into 6, into king, pump 8s and 9s. No, just going for knockdown. So again, this leaves him in a worse position than if he had just dumped his entire hand. But that's just stuff you learn. Let's have a look and see what UTRALAW is working with here as Oni. Man, I wish I could... Okay, good. He's got hand sorting on. He's about to start rearranging his hand. I think from this position, you just block. Just go for a 6 block. Your 6s aren't very valuable. Okay, yeah, wake up queen is fine too. Wake up queen is never wrong. Definitely want to spend all of your queens in the early game before your 9s become incredible finishers. Yeah, it's so sharp it cuts into another dimension, Mordred. Yeah, there you go. See, Mystic Deadman knows. Okay, he's got the ace attached, defends himself from a 3. Good position here. Doesn't have any face cards to take advantage of this, but that's fine. Bearsona doesn't know that. Yeah, I'm hoping we're going to see some Pogo Champ here. Yeah. Dodging is excellent. Okay, good blocks. Yeah, so UTRALAW is playing like textbook versus new player strats right now. Go for optimal combos, so he's revealing 8s and 10s when he's got them. He's dodging when he doesn't have any face cards. Oh, the disrespectful dodge. Or the disrespectful block. Oni does have the nice advantage of having 0.2 speed throws. So his 7 throw is actually really good. Especially with a 10 card hand, he can deal 15 off of that. That's not too bad. Not very card efficient, but not too bad at all. Got all the cards in the world now. He's going to save that jack until he's got a second jack to pair it with. So that when he wins combat with it, it's going to deal 35 damage. Ooh! Gets gribbled, though. He is too scared of playing an attack. Okay, Bearsona does not combo. Gets him on the ground, gets rid of the Joker. Onimaru now confined to 45 hit points, unless he can find a secret emergency Joker. It's like Floor Turkey in Castlevania. Just all of a sudden randomly discover like a whole bunch of free hit points. Yeah, 6 block, the most conservative option there. Just gets more cards. Looking for that Joker. Bearsona could be falling into kind of a trap where he's not revealing the same combat option two turns in a row. And if UTRALAW catches on to that, he can exploit it. Because it basically means that on a turn after somebody attacks, I only have to think about beating Blodge and Throw. So that means, as Onimaru, you probably 7 throw, because that hats your, you know, best chance of covering all available options. Okay, goes for the block instead. UTRALAW has got to go in. I think at this point you just play either the Queen or the Jacks. There we go. Lands the Queen, conserves the 9. Yeah, the queen makes more sense as a combat reveal, actually, in retrospect. Because if you play the Jacks into that combat reveal, you now have to spend the 9. And then you no longer are safe against Queen reveal from Bearsona. There we go. And that will be game unless Bearsona has the Joker. Or UTRALAW believes that he has the Joker and lets him live. But I think you combo Jack 100% of the time here. You lose nothing by doing it. Yeah, face down, but there we go. And that is it. UTRALAW cleans it up, taking game 4. Nicely played, UTRALAW. And congrats, Bearsona, on your first online tournament match. And thanks everybody for watching. Hope you learned a little bit about the game. Tried to make it a little bit more interesting by talking about some other stuff. Let me know if you enjoyed the discussion. And yeah, if you want to get in on this action, again, 19XX tournament is still open until the beginning of February. So check that out on the Serling Games forum if you would like. Link in the description below. And until next time, enjoy yourself some Yomi.